February 6, Wednesday. Memorial of Saints Pedro Bautista, Paul Miki, and companions, martyrs. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus departed from there and came to his native place, accompanied by his disciples. When the Sabbath came, he began to teach in the synagogue, and many who heard him were astonished. They said, "Where did this man get all this? What kind of wisdom has been given to him? What mighty deeds are wrought by his hands? Is he not the carpenter, the son of Mary, and the brother of James and Joseph and Judas and Simon? And are not his sisters here with us?" And they took offense at him. Jesus said to them, "A prophet is not without honor, except in his native place, and among his own kin, in his own house." So he was not able to perform any mighty deed there, apart from curing a few sick people, by laying his hands on them. He was amazed at their lack of faith. The Gospel of the Lord. Is he not the carpenter? Because we usually use our ordinary human reasoning, we are often prevented from seeing and appreciating extraordinary things. We may be truly impressed by the singing of a person, but when we realize that the person is just our next-door neighbor, our admiration may vanish before the person's ordinariness. The people of Nazareth witnessed the wondrous deeds of Jesus and the gracious wisdom of his words, but their initial amazement turns into disbelief, hatred, and rejection. Jesus is shocked by the sudden shift in the reaction of the people that he feels constrained to perform only a few cures. Indeed, how true it is what Jesus says that no prophet is honored in his own hometown. Our own people somehow bring us down to their level. Do we associate God's presence only with extraordinary events and outstanding people? Do we realize that God's abiding presence is also in the ordinary?